Hello, kids.
Hi, Grandpa. What are we going to learn today? We are very eager to listen.
Sure. Last week, we learnt about the unsung heroes who contributed to the freedom movement of our country. How about we learn about an unsung hero who is not noticed for his hard work and great achievement in the field of science?
Unsung hero in the field of science? Grandpa, this sounds really interesting. Who is he, Grandpa?
Shivkar Bapuji Talpade.
What did he achieve that went unnoticed?
Yes, yes, I shall explain. Shivkar Bapuji Talpade was the man who invented the modern aircraft.
Modern aircraft?
Yes.
Grandpa, we cannot wait to hear more about him. Please let us know, Grandpa.
Sure.
But, isn't it Wright brothers who invented the aircraft? Yes, that is what we learnt.
It is unfortunate that the real history is hidden. In my opinion, we should be taught about Shivkar Bapuji Talpade when it comes to aircraft.
Grandpa, who is he and what did he achieve in the field of aviation?
As mentioned in your books, the Wright brothers flew the first flight in 1903 and are recognized as the inventors of aircraft, right?
Yes.
But did you know? In 1895, that is 8 years before the Wright brothers flew their first flight, Shivkar Bapuji Talpade successfully flew an aircraft without any pilot.
Really? Unnamed aircraft?
Yes, my dear. He flew it over the Chowpatty Beach, Mumbai. He named it Marut Sakha. Talpade was born in 1864 in South Bombay. He belonged to Pathare Prabhu family. He worked as an instructor in the art and craft department in the Sir J.J. School of Arts, Mumbai. He was a great Sanskrit scholar and read as many scriptures as he could. He always searched the ancient Vedic scriptures about the making of an aircraft. It was his dream to learn how a man could fly in an aircraft. He thoroughly went through the Vaimanika Shastra.
Vaimanika Shastra?
Yes. Vaimanika Shastra, as per our ancient scriptures, describes aeronautics theory in detail.
That's awesome. We had books ready to learn about making of an aircraft.
Yes. His quest for learning more about it was never-ending. Finally, he met Pandit Subbaraya Shastri, who guided him and handed him bundles of scriptures which contained the formulae or sutras for making an aircraft. These were written by the great Rishi Bharadwaj.
Rishi Bharadwaj?
Yes, Nani. India was always the richest in knowledge, culture and heritage. We had such great sages throughout our history of thousands of years who have written formulae on how to make an aircraft.
What? But how?
Talpade says, as written in the Sanskrit Vaimanika Shastras, aeronautics is described in 8 chapters, 500 principles and 3000 shlokas, including 32 techniques to fly an aircraft. Only one principle covers how to make an engine as well as an aircraft. Then just imagine what knowledge all the 500 principles would have given us.
Wow!
That was Bharat. And then, it was the big day where he had to test the aircraft he constructed. crowd started gathering, curious to know about what was happening. Justice Govind Ranade and Maharaja Gaikwad of Baroda were among them. He flew the aircraft pilotless, noiseless. It towered into the sky with great speed and reached about 1500 feet high. He could safely land the aircraft successfully. The crowd started cheering on the success of the very first flight, Marut Sakha, constructed and flown by Shivkar Bapuji Talpade.
What does Marut Sakha means?
Marut means air and Sakha means friend. The Maharaja was overjoyed and rewarded Talpade. Talpade instead requested for financial help for making more aircrafts. The very next day, his achievement was even published in the then famous newspaper Kesari, published by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. As always, the British government wasn't happy on such success. They warned the Maharaja against funding Talpade, and he had to oblige. Then came the Raleigh brothers from Europe. They came to India to meet Talpade and offered financial help to construct more aircrafts. Not knowing their cunning intentions, Talpade innocently believed them by signing a deal. He handed over the drawings and documentation of the same. They left India and never got back to Talpade.
This is wrong. They cheated him.
Then the drawings get into the hands of the Americans and the Wright brothers construct their aircraft. They got all the recognition for the invention. But do you know, their prototype fell down after flying for about 120 feet in their first attempt.
Well, that had to happen.
After few years, in 1916, Talpade passed away, and the reason is unknown. And thus, the story of a successful scientist ended. Talpade, who utilized the ancient knowledge of Sanskrit texts to fly an aircraft, was never honored for his success. Instead, the world honors Wright brothers for their achievement. In fact, NASA is presently constructing a Mercury Vortex engine to design a solar-powered airplane. Talpade had already used this technology in the aircraft he constructed decades ago.
That's really, really sad. It is time that we start sharing such untold stories with our fellow Indians and make them aware about our heroes and their achievements. Yes! I agree with you. Talpade is such a great inspiration. But don't you feel the importance of learning Sanskrit and keeping it alive?
That is so true, my dear. Wonderful.
Sanskrit is the most ancient and resourceful language in the world.
There are more such unsung heroes who have not been recognized by the world for their achievements, success and hard work. Let's talk about them soon. Till then, bye kids.
Bye, Grandpa.